This is an STL file that I want to 3D print. The problem is that the triangles, the tessellation is very large, and it's not going to look good when I print it because it's not the effect I want. If it were the effect, then it would look good. But ignore what kind of model this is. It's something the customer wants in their knife handle. So it's an example I have to use because it's the one that's has a really low resolution. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to bring this into Meshmixer. And so here I've imported the Meshmixer. And Meshmixer, you can see where all the triangles are, but Meshmixer kind of applies a kind of a tangential property to the edges to make it smoother. So it has an automatic smoothing of the texture. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to first select all. So I go up to select, Control A, and select everything. Go to Edit, Remesh, and there it's already made, remeshed into a bunch of smaller triangles. So adaptive density does some amount of smoothing. Here you can see it says smooth group boundaries. So if I deselect that, I don't see any difference if I deselect it. But it definitely does some amount of smoothing. So reselect that smooth group boundaries. And I want to increase the density a little bit. And even some more. It's looking pretty smooth. The triangles are pretty small. This hand is going to be small too, so this should be good enough here. I can try even a little bit more, see what that does. There we go. Why not? Accept that. Escape of the selection. And now let's go and export that. Export. Go back to the printing software and pull it open in here. Smoothest. It's tiny, so we have to just increase the scale here. There we go. So now we have a hand that is much smoother than previously. Rotate it. And so you can see side by side that it's smoothed out. The triangles are smaller. Kind of did some averaging and smoothing. That's going to make a better print. It's going to look better. Okay, and that's it. I'm sure there are other techniques. If you know of any other techniques, go ahead and post them in the comments and share those too. I'd like to see what other techniques are out there for smoothing a model that is rough like this.